Updates to the Google search algorithm can cause our rankings to rise and fall, but how do we know when an update is happening in the first place and what can we do about it? Details inside the video. Hey, it's Gia from Brand24, and today I want to talk about the Google search algorithm. Now, Google is notoriously low-key when it comes to their search algorithm. Most of their broader algorithm updates are spotted by members of the SEO community before they're confirmed by Google. And with limited documentation available, it's really hard to be 100% certain of what each update is targeting and whether it's going to impact our search rankings positively or negatively, which is why we really need to keep an eye on our web traffic on a regular basis so we're able to detect indicators that a Google algorithm change is coming. But before we continue, there are just a few things to keep in mind about the Google search algorithm. So when we say that Google is low-key about their search algorithm, we mean that they don't really announce any algorithm updates at all. I mean, sometimes they'll confirm it, but that's usually reserved for much bigger core updates and often done through their Twitter handle at Search Liaison. So Google's aversion to informing the general public about their algorithmic updates might be related in small part to the fact that they update their algorithm so frequently. They actually do it every single day and sometimes multiple times a day, and the regular changes that they implement can be so minute that we don't even notice them. On the other hand, when they make bigger and more extensive updates to their algorithm, it's usually not something that can be observed in a day. It's a process that can take weeks. So you really need to be tracking your search rankings on a regular basis to be able to notice something out of the ordinary. And if you do see something unusual, like 19 different search results instead of the standard 10 for page one, then you know that Google's up to something. So there are a few different ways that you can detect an upcoming update to the Google search algorithm. And it all starts with keeping a close eye on your web traffic and your search rankings, which is hopefully something that you're already doing. To better understand the way that Google's algorithm works, just try observing your search rankings from different sides. Search for your keywords on Chrome as well as other browsers, using both regular and private mode. So you'll probably see that you rank differently for the same keywords on different browsers and in different modes, which is confusing but also not that surprising. The main thing to understand here is that Google prioritizes personalization. So even if you're searching in private mode, Google will still use cookies and other types of identification data to show you the most personalized results that are relevant to your search. This means that it's hard to track unbiased results, which can be a little frustrating. But one way to bypass this is by using tools like SEMrush. It has a feature that lets you look at your keyword rankings as if you were searching from a different location, which is really helpful if you're a digital marketing agency serving clients that are out of state or from different countries. Now, whether you're observing things manually or utilizing tools, what you're looking for is fluctuations in your web traffic and search rankings. A noticeable increase or decrease in your web traffic can have several causes. It might be from direct traffic. There's a video that talks about direct traffic, about how to identify where it's coming from, but it could also easily be the result of a recent update to the Google search algorithm. At this point, you want to see if there have been any fluctuations in the search rankings for your keywords. So there are a number of tools that can help you track this. Moz has their Mozcast, AccuRanker has their Google Grump rating, while SEMrush has their SERP volatility sensor. If you see large fluctuations in your search rankings, there's a good chance that Google's search algorithm is getting a big update. So keep in mind that these tend to go on for a while, sometimes weeks, and during this time, your rankings can rise, fall, and then just go right back to where they were to begin with. So you don't need to panic at the first sign of an update. In the meantime, however, one way to stay proactive during a big algorithm update is by making sure that your website measures up to Google's EAT guidelines, which is a fundamental part of their algorithm. Google rewards websites that show expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness with higher search rankings. So it's important to ensure that your content demonstrates knowledge and expertise, since this helps your site build authority, especially if you have plenty of mentions and quality backlinks to show that you're a trustworthy source. So you can read more about Google's EAT guidelines inside their Search Quality Evaluator Guidelines. I'm putting a link to it below in the description for the video. It's a little long, but it will give you some much-needed insight into Google's search algorithm and what it's trying to achieve. So I also recommend following Google at Search Liaison on Twitter. Even though they don't announce algorithm updates directly, they are in the habit of sharing content that's related to upcoming updates, like when they put out this article, Ways to Succeed in Google News, which was followed shortly by an algorithm update targeting news sites. Looking at the latest tweets from Search Liaison today, it looks like their most recent update, the March 2019 core update, is focused on search relevance as opposed to content quality. And that is it for this week. Next time, I'll be sharing a few best practices that you can apply to make sure that your Google search rankings are ready for any algorithm update. If you have any questions or something to add, just let me know in the comments section below. And if you found this video helpful, feel free to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, where I will be explaining how to do even more in social media and digital marketing each week. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you learned something new, and I'll see you next time. Bye.